Good morning, America. Steve Eisen here. It's a beautiful day here in South Carolina in Lexington County. It's Friday, 27th of April, 2012, and it's election time here in Lexington County. And as always, it's most interesting around election time. We have a number of candidates around the county, and today it's an honor to have Jim Eckstrom, our treasurer for Lexington County. Jim is a conservative. He's running on a Republican ticket, and he's here with us, first time visiting with the Cayce Mafia, which is a nonpartisan group here in South Carolina. We're here at Shawnee's, just a few minutes from downtown Columbia, near the airport. So if you're visiting South Carolina, come by and see us at 7 a.m. every Friday morning. Jim, it's a pleasure to have you with us.
Thank you so much, Steve. Appreciate it.
Jim, why are you running for office again?
I have a message. My message is that I believe I'm making a difference, Steve. And I'm looking forward to sharing that difference that I believe I'm making with you this morning.
Well, America, in just a few minutes, you're about to hear who I think is really a great treasurer for Lexington County, give you the reasons why he'll be running for office. So we'll hear Jim's discussion in a few minutes. And until next Friday, Steve Eisen signing off. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, next we have our featured speaker today is really needs no introduction. He's a conservative. He's an incumbent. Jim Eckstrom. He's our treasurer here in Lexington County. And Jim will come up and tell you why he's running for this office again and what he would like to do for the next 4 years. Jim Eckstrom, let's give him a round of applause.
Thank you, folks. Chairman Isom, I appreciate the invite to be here this morning. Mr. Gettings, it's tough to follow you. But what we have in common, we both have a message, okay? I'll say good morning. I'm Jim Eckstrom. I'm your county treasurer. It's an honor to be here today, and I'm pleased to say that I'm running because I believe I'm making the difference. Before I explain that difference, let me share with you a call I had with my 30-year-old daughter when I first learned that I had a challenger in the primary. I told her that I was in a contested election, and she said, "Dad, will you promise me one thing? Promise me that you won't engage in negative campaigning." She said, "Dad, you've got a message, and just stick to that message." Let me share with you that record and the difference I believe I'm making. I've worked to limit government, reduce government spending, as well as serve the taxpayer by putting the taxpayer first. Let me explain. In my 4 years of office, I've reduced staff from 23 to 18. At the same time, I've maintained and even increased taxpayer services. In 4 years, while inflation and county growth has risen 17%, I've reduced spending 3.5% in the treasurer's office. And I've been an advocate for the taxpayer in putting the interests in the taxpayer before the interests and concerns of the governing body. I don't know if you all, if you know it or not, the treasurer rules routinely in penalty waiver appeals. When I began office in 2008, there was way too great a culture of assuming the treasurer's office was always right and the taxpayer was wrong. I'm here to say that I've changed that culture. And I'm pleased to say that now I rule for the taxpayer unless there's clear and compelling evidence otherwise. So to recap my message is limited government, less government spending, and putting the taxpayer first. In closing, let me share with you an account of my previous term of public service before becoming your county treasurer. Back in 1969 and 70, I served in a helicopter unit in Vietnam. In an annual performance evaluation, my commanding officer wrote, and I quote, "Eckstrom's behavior in an area where temptation is readily available is above reproach," end quote. I've got to tell you, as a young man, that was a great, great encouragement to me. Now, fast forward over 40 years later, that's precisely what I would want the Cayce Mafia, the citizens and taxpayers of Lexington County to say about me. Eckstrom's behavior in an area where temptation is readily available. That temptation to engage in good old boy backroom politics for one's own personal gain is above reproach. If that could be said of me, I've kept my faith with the taxpayers and kept my integrity. I humbly ask for your vote and support and pledge to you 4 more years of savings, efficiency, and putting the taxpayer first. Thank you.
Thank you.
Any questions?
No questions,
Eckstrom. Are you running unopposed?
No.
No, I have a gentleman. But I'm running on my record.
Any more questions?
That's the shortest campaign speech I've ever heard. You got my vote.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. I will tell you this. That about 2 weeks ago, Steve called me on a Saturday afternoon. And I was just sitting there thinking about this. And I said, do you have a couple minutes? And I just ran through. And so he was my sounding board, and I worked to keep it concise and keep your attention, okay?
Well, I appreciate the things you said, especially about protecting the taxpayer and ruling in favor of the taxpayer.
That's huge. That is huge. And that is the culture. That is now the culture in the treasurer's office. Thank you.
Jim, I spent about an hour this week with Chris Harmon, the auditor. And Chris Harmon told me that he could not imagine anybody to better work with Jim than Jim Eckstrom.
All right.
He said, you know, the treasurer and the auditor have to work really close together. Yep. He said, we really do it well. Jim is super good, and I've never had a problem with anything I've ever gone to him with. It's just been, you know, just a pleasure to work with him. So
thank you. Hey, let me just tell you, when I came in office, there was the treasurer, the auditor, and the assessor, and there were walls between them. They just didn't get along. And I had been in office one day, and I told Chris Harmon, I said, these walls have to come down because they are keeping us from serving the taxpayer. There's no better way to serve the taxpayer than we all get along. And then we can be a united front. So I thank you very much for those remarks.
Will you pay my tax bill? If you pay my property tax on my car, if you pay that, I'll vote for you.
On the property tax receipts, I have a note that if you have any ideas how to save taxpayer dollars, I'd like to personally hear from you. I get very, very many cards with ideas, and we're implementing those ideas. Let me just very quickly tell you one. We have state organizations. I've got to go to training. I've got to go to training that's mandated by the state. And I find that they've been talking for 10 plus years on efficiencies. And one of them was when we take a car payment, when we take an auto tax payment, we send the data to the DMV to send you the registration. This is through the mail. And then we mail out a separate receipt.
Yeah, why? That doesn't make sense.
It doesn't make sense. They've been talking about it in committees. I said, this doesn't make sense. There is enough space on that DMV form to put the property tax receipt. And the talk was, well, every individual treasurer wants to customize their own receipt. I said, we aren't working for ourselves, we're working for the taxpayers. I, with the help of Chip Huggins, went to Colonel Schwedo, the new director of DMV, executive director of DMV, and we are coming out with, we've lined up the treasurers in the state. We're going to come out with the tax bill with the registration, and it will save Lexington County alone $50,000 a year.
Very good.
So I'm very, very pleased with that.
No, I was just going to draw a contrast. You've been very, very generous in not mentioning your opponent and some of his failings, but I won't be so generous. You've talked about how you've saved taxpayer money. You've reduced office staff. You've reduced your budget by, I think you said, 3.5% over the last 4 years. At the same time,
while inflation and county growth has risen 70%.
Right, exactly. So while you've been doing this, your opponent, while sitting on county council, Mr. Banning, has voted to raise our taxes in this down economy when people are struggling and trying to meet their own bills. When county council wants to spend money, they just raise our taxes. So there's a big contrast between yourself and your opponent, and I just wanted to make sure that gets pointed out.
I think it's also worth noting that since you're being very gracious, I won't. Your opponent is running for your office, but somehow has not seen fit to step down from the office he occupies.
Yeah.
So he's trying to keep his foot in two camps just to see which pans out that way.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. I will say that I alluded to my initial term of public service over 40 years ago in Vietnam. And now I'm your county treasurer. The way I came to this job, I was reaching the end of my career in public business. Bill Rowell, the then sitting county treasurer, was gravely ill, and Mr. Rowell recommended to the governor that I finish his term. The governor appointed me. That's how I got here. This is not a stepping stone, okay? I am committed to serving the citizens, taxpayers of Lexington County as their treasurer in this. I want to stress, this is not a stepping stone for me at all.
How long have you been serving as treasurer?
4.5 years.
Okay.
4.5 years. And I will say I'll continue to serve as long as you put me in this office, as long as I'm making a difference for you. That's the key. The message, you brought that up. Why are you doing it? Because I believe I'm making a difference.
I will.
Thank you. I'm going to run on my record, purely on my record. Thank you.
Okay, let's give him a round of applause. Thank you.